If you're operating.
In May this year, the country legalized organ transplants when the president signed the bill into law. This gave a sigh of relief to the patients who were seeking for this service abroad, especially the kidney patients.
But we cannot say because this surgery has not been done by Ugandan, therefore we are not doing it. No, let's first have it on the ground. So what's our plan in Mulago? We have got a team which has been training us since 2014. They are the very same ones who are going to come and now work with us on Ugandans in Uganda.
However, during a news conference today in Kampala, the top Ugandan medical surgeons openly said that they are not ready to start conducting organ transplants. This can only be achieved within a period of 2 to 3 years when most of the things are put in order, such as more trainings to the medical surgeons, installing more equipment in the hospitals, among others.
And we estimate that to be within a period of 24 to 36 months. So Ugandan surgeons may not be ready, but Uganda is getting ready to do its maiden transplant.
Asima disclosed that the country at the moment has only 2 transplant surgeons.
We are 2. Don't worry. And this was tactical, because you could easily have a whole team of 30 transplant surgeons waiting for transplant and begin fighting. So it's okay. So when we start, the 2 will start, okay, because they will be a little bit ahead of the others. But even before the actual transplant starts, transplant surgery does not begin with the actual transplant. It begins with many other things. Other modes of transplant training will start.
Strict regulations are already in place to make sure that organ transplant is not abused, and the Uganda Organ and Transplant Council is expected to put in place tougher regulations to look into complaints of stealing organs from the patients.
Very lucrative. So there is nowhere in the world where there is selling. It's not there. The only exceptions might be a government-based compensation of the donor. But once you open the window for compensation, where does it end?
Relatedly, for the next 5 years, getting organs from the dead is prohibited. If caught, one risks imprisonment for 12 years or a fine of 2 billion shillings.
If you are found to have participated in an illegality, one, you are imprisoned for 12 years. Fine, 2 billion, okay? And you can have both imprisonment and or the 2 billion. Your license is retracted for 5 years. The hospital where you did it, is closed. So the stakes are way, way, way too high.
Story by Jelet Namuwaya for the news.